The first antibiotic was discovered in 1928 by Alexander Fleming. Ever since then, doctors have been warning that an overuse of antibiotics could lead us one day to a post-antibiotic era, where drug-resistant superbugs have grown immune to antibiotics and infections can no longer be held at bay. Well, according to Robert Redfield, the director of the CDC, the post-antibiotic era is already here. Welp, fuck. In March 1942, Ann Miller, a 33-year-old woman, was near death at New Haven Medical Center in Michigan, suffering from a strep infection, a common cause of death 70 years ago. The infection had made it into her bloodstream, and her condition seemed bleak. She'd been hospitalized for a month, often delirious, with her temperature spiking to nearly 107 degrees. Her doctors had tried everything to save her, including drugs, blood transfusions, and surgery. All had failed. On March 14th, she was very near to death, and her doctors, desperate to save her, administered an experimental drug, penicillin. Discovered 14 years earlier, the drug had been shown effective at killing bacteria in petri dishes. Miraculously, in just hours she recovered, becoming the first person in the modern world to be saved by an antibiotic. Rather than dying in her 30s, Ann Miller would live another 57 years, to reach the ripe old age of 90. But now, the CDC director cautions the news from reporting on a post-antibiotic era, when antibiotics are no longer effective at fighting off even commonplace bacteria, saying, "We're living in a time when some miracle drugs no longer perform miracles, and families have been ripped apart by a microscopic enemy." Today, more than a half century later, germs like the one that infected Ann Miller, which once killed millions, are now making a resurgence as they become increasingly resistant to antibiotics. In 2017, drug-resistant superbugs in the US infected 2.8 million people and caused more than 35,000 deaths, up more than 50% from just 4 years prior. And competing reports from the Washington University School of Medicine estimate that drug-resistant bacteria kill nearly 5 times more than that a year, as hospitals attribute deaths from infections to other primary causes, like cancer. Even on the low end, that would mean an infection every 11 seconds and a death every 15 minutes. Antibiotics are among the most commonly prescribed drugs for people, and they're even given to livestock to prevent diseases in tightly packed herds. Unfortunately, many antibiotics prescribed to people and animals are unnecessary, like in response to viruses, like those that cause colds and the flu. And it's this overuse that breeds drug resistance. When used properly, antibiotics can help destroy disease-causing bacteria. But if you take an antibiotic when you have a viral infection, like the flu, the drug won't affect the viruses, making you sick. Instead, it will destroy a wide variety of bacteria in your body, including some of the good bacteria that help you digest food, fight infection, and stay healthy. Bacteria that are tough enough to survive the drug will have a chance to grow and quickly multiply after their friends were wiped away. These drug-resistant strains can then spread to other people and even pass this drug resistance to other bacteria via transformation, a process that allows bacteria to exchange genetic information. Even worse, if a person is prescribed antibiotics for 2 weeks but stops after a week when they feel better, the bacteria have an even better chance of having been able to survive this smaller regimen, and thus gained some antibiotic resistance. According to the NIH, some bacterial infections that were treatable for decades are now resistant to almost every drug, even the newer ones. Last year, the CDC published a report identifying 18 bacteria and fungi that needed to be monitored for developing antibiotic resistance, including 5 bugs described as urgent threats. These 5 urgent threats include Candida auris, a drug-resistant fungus that began spreading among hospital and nursing home patients in the United States in 2015. Carprobipenem-resistant Acinetobacter, which can cause pneumonia and other infections in hospital ICUs, and an antibiotic-resistant strain of gonorrhea. And now, brand new superbugs like NDM1 have emerged that are resistant to almost all known agents, including the most powerful last line of carprobipenem antibiotics. These organisms are highly resistant, and the infections they cause have proven to be extremely difficult to eradicate. And the CDC estimates that these new resistant strains cost the US healthcare industry more than $20 billion a year. One study found that even after the use of a disinfectant, more than half of hospital rooms still contained detectable amounts of a drug-resistant bacteria. Nurses and doctors even carry these things around too. Roughly 5% of healthcare workers are colonized with MRSA, a drug-resistant bacteria that kills thousands of people in the US every year. And the World Health Organization agrees. Their recent global report paints a grim reality. If we're not able to implement effective strategies to curtail antimicrobial resistance, common serious infections caused by bacteria that were once treatable, like bloodstream and skin infections, diarrhea, pneumonia, and urinary tract infections, will become harder to manage and ultimately fatal. The CDC warns we need to stop relying only on new antibiotics that are slow to get to market, that will only delay these germs before they one day render even these new antibiotics ineffective. But the CDC's report highlighted practices like more thoughtful use of antibiotics, controlling existing infections, and improving cleaning and disinfecting practices that can keep the germs away and infections from occurring in the first place. Hopefully, if aggressive strategies are implemented, antibiotics will continue to save lives for generations to come. That's it for this episode of Everything Science. But what do you think about antibiotics? Should we save ourselves while we can and try to help those future generations? If you made it this far, you probably liked the video. So consider subscribing so you always get notified when we post a video. And remember, there's always more to learn.